Thank you very much. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Jackie Kwok. For this project, I have two research collaborators, Ms. Cole and Mr. Zhang. They are in the hall. And the title of my presentation is the Making of a Place of Health, the Making of a Place of Culture, the Case of a Duckling Hill Cultural Garden Designed and Built by Older People. Professor Ye has just talked about how to overcome overcrowding in Hong Kong. And if I understand correctly, he mentioned that we have to control the cleanliness of the place. We have to have a programmed space and controlled behavior of the people. And I'm just speaking of the opposite direction. Okay. The aim of this presentation is to illustrate a paradigm shift in regard to the discussion of health in the urban environment and the issue of aging. As I have only 5 minutes, firstly, I would like to introduce the case of study first before I develop the theoretical explanation. Let me introduce... I'm sorry. First, let me introduce the site of study. In this map, you can see that the site, Zhang Guan O, is very far away from the place, the central. It is around 40 or 50 kilometers away from here. And Duckling Hill is near the Poland Underground Railway Station. And next to the very densely populated region of public housing. Okay. The area of Zhang Guan O is about 10 square kilometer. It is the size. It is a newly developed town in the 1980s. You can see that it is a site at the social periphery and a place, you can say that it is a place that evoke no nostalgia and fascination. And yet, we see some extraordinary phenomena in this place. Next to the Poland Public Housing Estate, there is the Duckling Hill hiking route. Along the route, you can find facilities designed and built by older people. They are all illegal constructions. Okay, the older people reuse lots of waste material to redesign and construct the hiking routes. They put chairs and benches along the route. They use waste materials to build fences and handrails. And they construct a garden near the hilltop. It is a place for planting flowers. They build pavilions. And may I introduce Mr. Chen. He is the designer and builder of a staircase of 200 steps to the hilltop. And with a helper, Mr. Chen used concrete and iron to build the staircase. And some other older people give names to the places they build and write poems to glorify nature and the happiness of old age. So, Mr. Cole, he designed and crafted the walking sticks for hiking. Of course, the government, just like what Professor Ye has said, of course, the government consider the construction as illegal. The pavilion built by the older people are all demolished by the government because they consider it is not safe. At the moment, the older neighbor actively participate in the campaign for constructing a cultural park. And then they draw a map indicating their design ideas. So what does the case tell? Why did the older people design and build illegally with their hands and the hiking landscape? This wonderful case is a perfect illustration of the theoretical view of post-medical geography of health and that of successful aging. Okay, you can see that what they do actually connects well with the ideas of successful aging. The older people, by redesigning and reconstructing a hiking route on their own, they participate and engage intensively in life. And then they urge for concrete landmark for success and accomplishment. Actually, what they want to build a staircase is a concrete landmark for success. So now I come to my conclusion. We have to employ a new paradigm to understand the issue of health, and especially that of health-related aging. Besides the biomedical model and the socio-psychological model, we need a cultural model to understand aging. The cultural model states older people continue to see life full of possibilities. Actually, if we see the issue from the approach of post-medical geography of health, we see that people do not just need a network of healthcare delivery. Post-medical geography of health emphasizes on the people's subjectivity, experience of place, and the knowledge of place as object. In our case, older people actively shape the space, creating landmarks of achievement and expression of identity. This tells us that a city needs space to enable people to express actively. It is not just for the younger generation, but also for the older citizens. Actually, as the World Health Organization defines health as a state of complete physical, social, and mental well-being, and not merely absence of disease and infirmity, we can see that what occurs in a local place, how people act there, has a profound importance to health. So, what we want to advocate is that open space should be seriously considered as a place for social and cultural activities. So, actually, I think open space, freedom in open space is a very significant issue of health we need to discuss and develop in Hong Kong in depth. Okay, this is the end of my presentation. Thank you.